जय हिंद व्यूअर्स, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर सुखविंदर सिंह ढिल्लन। आई एम वर्किंग एज एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर एट अजय कुमार गर्ग इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज गाजियाबाद। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस शेडेड पोल इंडक्शन मोटर। इट इज़ स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ सिंगल फेज इंडक्शन मोटर। इट डजेंट रिक्वायर स्प्लिट फेज कॉन्सेप्ट एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर दैट फॉर स्मूद running of the induction motor or self starting of the induction motor we need to split two phase, okay, for creating the rotating magnetic field. But in this motor again we need the rotating magnetic field. I have already told that rotating magnetic field is the much required concept for developing the running torque or developing the torque in a particular direction, okay. But in this particular motor the concept is a little bit different to create the rotating magnetic field. See here, in this particular construction of shaded pole induction motor, it is consist of salient pole type construction at the stator. Okay. Then we have to cut the pole face in such a way so as to insert a copper ring, copper thick copper ring over here. And this cut is at 1/4 of the pole face, okay. And you can see here we have the copper bar, copper ring, and here we have the copper ring, okay. Let me redraw it. Here we have the copper rings, okay, on both the poles. And this is a salient pole type construction, as I have already told. Now, how the running magnetic field or the rotating magnetic field will develop by this particular construction of the stator poles. Okay. Here we have the single phase supply, there is no other another winding, okay. Just with the help of this type of construction of shaded pole construction, we can create the rotating magnetic field. I will discuss each and everything one by one. You can see the shaded pole induction motor based on the three basic region. The working of shaded pole induction motor is can be explained with the help of these three regions. When the flux changes its value from 0 to nearly maximum positive value according to the sinusoidal input voltage. It starts from 0, goes to the maximum, then it start decreasing, okay, and reaches to the 0 at 180 degree. To that particular input voltage cycle, how the rotating magnetic field develop on the stator pole, okay. And this is categorized or it is classified into the three basic concepts. When the flux changes from its value 0 to maximum, when the flux remains almost constant at its maximum value, when this happen we will discuss, okay. When the flux decreases from maximum positive value to 0 at 180 degree of the cycle of supply voltage. See here in the next slide, suppose we have the sinusoidal input single phase supply like this, okay. This is the supply voltage V s and this one is the V max with respect to omega t. And corresponding to the change of the supply voltage with respect to frequency from 0 to maximum, this is our first region, little bit here. Then from suppose this is A point, from A to B we have considered this region. When there is a when the amplitude of the voltage remains almost constant, there is no large variation in the amplitude of the or magnitude of the supply voltage, okay. Then after that B to C at 180 degree of the cycle, half cycle, B to C there is a another decrement of the voltage. Voltage amplitude decrease and here it increase and A to B remains C, B to C starts decreasing. And for these three regions, नंबर वन फॉर सप्लाई वोल्टेज साइकिल हाफ साइकिल 0 to A O to A. There is let me erase just for discussion. I need this space. Here we can write this thing O to A. Rise in voltage near to maximum and hence rate of change of flux is large. Okay. For A to B, voltage amplitude remains almost same. And hence d phi by dt for this particular region is very small because it is almost linear, almost constant. Okay, if the voltage is constant, current for this A to B region is almost same, that is why there is no change or change d phi by dt is very small, negligibly small. We can also suppose d phi by dt is near to 0. Okay. But for B to C, voltage decreases to 0, but rate of change of flux is again large or maximum. O to A, the rate of change of flux is large corresponding to the input voltage and hence the current, because if the voltage is sinusoidal and hence the current is also sinusoidal and then the flux is also sinusoidal. We have assumed the thing. Okay. A to B, there is no very large change. We cannot see any large change from A to B portion, A to B region. Then B to C, decrement of voltage to the 0, but the rate of change is again large, but in the reverse direction to the previous one. From O to A. Here it is rising, this portion for rising of amplitude and this portion for decaying. Here it is almost constant. See, for this half cycle, how the rotating magnetic field is developed on the poles, we can see. When the supply is given to the stator, then there is a flux setup. Okay. As we give the supply, then magnetic lines of forces are coming like this. Now, what will happen for this shaded portion? फॉर ओ टू ए देयर इज ए लार्ज चेंज. ठीक है, फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर लार्ज चेंज, फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर लार्ज डी फाइव बाई डी टी, ई एम एफ इंड्यूस्ड, ई एम एफ इंड्यूस्ड एज पर फैराडेज लॉ लॉ ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर लार्ज चेंज फॉर पोर्शन ओ टू ए. वी आर डिस्कसिंग फॉर दिस ओ टू ए पोर्शन, देन वी हैव टू डिस्कस अबाउट ए टू बी पोर्शन, देन द एम्पलीट्यूड फॉर बी टू सी पोर्शन. ठीक है, नाउ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन, फैराडेज लॉ ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन, दिस इज द फर्स्ट वन. वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट फैराडेज लॉ, फर्स्ट लॉ एंड सेकेंड लॉ इन आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर. नाउ द सेकेंड कॉन्सेप्ट कम्स हियर, दैट इज लेंज लॉ. लेंज इज लॉ, द सेकेंड वन इज लेंज लॉ. दिस विल क्रिएट द होल थिंग, लेंज इज लॉ. ड्यू टू दिस हाई रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ फ्लक्स, ई एम एफ इंड्यूस्ड इन द कॉपर बार और कॉपर रिंग विच इज इंसर्टेड टू दिस पोल, एंड ड्यू टू दिस ई एम एफ इंड्यूस्ड एज द कॉपर रिंग इज ए क्लोज सर्किट, एज द कॉपर रिंग इज ए क्लोज सर्किट, देन देयर इज ए करंट. ओके, ड्यू टू दैट करंट बिल्ड अप इन द कॉपर रिंग देयर इज ए फ्लक्स, इट्स ओन फ्लक्स इज सेटअप. सी दिस कॉपर रिंग विल सेटअप इट्स ओन फ्लक्स, एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू लेंज़'स लॉ दिस फ्लक्स इज इन ऑपोजिट डायरेक्शन टू द कॉज विच प्रोड्यूसेज इट. लेंज़'स लॉ वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिफाइंड इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स. लेंज़'स लॉ स्टेट्स दैट इट व्हेन देयर इज ए EMF induced across the winding, that EMF is always is in opposite direction to the cause which produces it. Similarly, here these flux lines of forces creates due to this O to A portion, these magnetic lines of forces links with the shaded portion or the copper ring creates an EMF. According to Faraday's law and according to Lenz law, this EMF creates its current, and due to that current there is a flux, and that flux is in opposite direction to this rate of change of flux which is coming for this O to A portion. Okay, and due to the opposition offered by the copper ring flux, all the magnetic lines of forces of the pole gets diverted to this side because it oppose to the main flux to flow through this shaded portion. That's why all the magnetic lines of forces get diverted here, they doesn't come through the shaded portion because it oppose these magnetic lines of forces, it opposes the cause which produces it. Okay, produces the EMF, EMF then current then flux, it create its own flux, copper ring created the flux which opposite to the main flux, and hence all the lines of forces comes here in the unshaded portion. So for this portion O to A we can say magnetic lines of forces of the main pole flux, main pole we can say magnetic lines of forces of the main pole get diverted टू द अन और अनशेडेड और नॉन शेडेड पोर्शन पोर्शन, ठीक है, बाय द बाय द अपोजिंग नेचर ऑफ बाय द और वी कैन से बाय द अपोजिशन बाय द अपोजिशन क्रिएटेड बाय विच वन शेडेड पोर्शन. ठीक है, नाउ कम टू द नेक्स्ट वन. फॉर द सेकेंड पोर्शन ए टू बी दिस एम्पलीट्यूड ऑलमोस्ट रिमेन सेम, दैट्स वाई द नेट चेंज इज ऑलमोस्ट निग्लिजिबल जीरो, दैट्स वाई डी फाइव बाई डी टी इज जीरो. इफ डी फाइव बाई डी टी इज जीरो देन द मैग्नेटिक लाइन्स ऑफ फोर्सेज ऑफ द मेन पोल कमिंग लाइक दिस. ओके, नाउ फॉर दिस ए टू बी डी फाइव बाई डी टी इज ऑलमोस्ट इक्वल्स टू जीरो. ओके, फॉर दिस ए टू बी पोर्शन देन ई एम एफ इंड्यूस्ड इज ऑलमोस्ट जीरो. इफ देयर इज नो ई एम एफ देन देयर इज नो करंट इन द कॉपर बार और कॉपर रिंग एंड हिंस देयर इज नो फ्लक्स प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द कॉपर रिंग. देयर इज नो ऑपोजिशन टू द मेन फ्लक्स एंड हिंस ऑल द मैग्नेटिक लाइन्स ऑफ फोर्सेस पास थ्रू द होल पोल स्पेस. ओके, दे कम्स आउट फ्रॉम द होल पोल स्पेस ऑफ द स्टेटर पोल एंड द नेट फ्लक्स लाइज एट द सेंटर ऑफ द पोल. दिस इज फाई नेट. ओके, एंड फॉर दिस प्रीवियस केस हेयर द कॉपर बार इंड्यूस्ड फ्लक्स कॉपर रिंग इंड्यूस्ड फ्लक्स हैज डाइवर्टेड द मैग्नेटिक लाइन्स ऑफ फोर्सेस टू द अनशेडेड पोर्शन. दैट्स वाई द नेट फ्लक्स और रिजल्टेंट फ्लक्स लाइज एट द सेंटर ऑफ अनशेडेड पोर्शन हेयर. दिस इज फ्लक्स फाइ एम, ठीक है, और फाइ नेट. सी हियर, फॉर द प्रीवियस और द फर्स्ट केस वी हैव द पोल फेस एरिया फॉर मैग्नेटिक लाइन्स ऑफ फोर्सेज दिस वन एंड फॉर द सेकेंड केस एज द ई एम एफ इंड्यूस्ड इन द शेडेड पोर्शन इज जीरो दैट्स वाई मैग्नेटिक लाइन्स ऑफ फोर्सेज और नेट फ्लक्स लाइज एट द सेंटर ऑफ द होल पोल फेस. इट कम्स हेयर. नाउ सी वट हैपन टू बी टू सी पोर्शन. ओके, दिस इज द लास्ट पोर्शन for decaying of the amplitude B to C. Again there is a large change, but now the change of d phi by dt in the reverse direction to the first case. Okay, for this particular case again magnetic lines of forces coming here. Now the magnitude of the or amplitude is decaying decreasing. ठीक है, फॉर दिस लार्ज रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ फ्लक्स बट इन द ऑपोजिट डायरेक्शन अगेन ई एम एफ इंड्यूस्ड इन द शेडेड पोर्शन ठीक है एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू लेंज लॉ this will oppose the first of all emf induced in the shaded portion then there is current induced. Okay, and after that flux, after induction of current then there is a flux. Okay, current flows through the induced rather than induce current flows through the copper ring, then we have the flux. Now, this flux set up by this shaded copper ring attract, in the previous case it opposed the magnetic lines of forces. Now, the rate of change is reversed, that is why the flux set up by the copper ring now attract all the magnetic lines of forces of unshaded portion to the shaded portion. Now, what will happen? This is the actual, let me highlight it. Now, all the magnetic lines of forces diverted from and few remains through this unshaded portion. All the magnetic lines of forces or maximum density of magnetic lines of forces now will flow through the shaded portion, comes here. Now, the EMF induced in the copper ring creates a current that will induce flux, that flux attract all the lines of forces from unshaded portion to shaded portion. Here we have all the magnetic lines of force diverted from shaded portion to unshaded portion. For the second case, EMF is 0, there is no opposition to the magnetic lines of forces, that is why this will follow the whole pole phase magnetic lines of forces. And for B to C, reverse of the first case, now magnetic lines of forces get diverted from unshaded to shaded portion, and the maximum strength of the field lies here, phi net comes here. Okay. What is the conclusion of this whole discussion from unshaded to shaded portion is that with the help of let me discuss in the next slide. See here, here is the at this center the maximum flux is here, then it comes here at the center of the whole pole phase, then comes at here. If you see the maximum flux set up by the single winding is seems to be rotating from unshaded portion to shaded portion like this. See here, here is the magnetic flux, net flux, and we can say the net or resultant flux is rotating in nature along the pole phase from unshaded portion to the shaded portion. Okay. Now, conclusion of the whole discussion is that with the help of shading copper ring in the pole phase, we can produce rotating magnetic field with resultant of phi max, which is rotating from unshaded portion टू शेडेड पोर्शन अलोंग द लेंथ ऑफ द पोल फेस ओके फॉर पोर्शन ओ टू ए देन ए टू बी एंड बी टू सी कॉरेस्पोंडिंग टू टू द साइकिल ऑफ कॉरेस्पॉन्डिंग टू द हाफ साइकिल ऑफ सप्लाई वोल्टेज दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द कंक्लूजन विद द हेल्प ऑफ शेडिंग कॉपर रिंग इन द पोल फेस वी कैन प्रोड्यूस रोटेटिंग मैग्नेटिक फील्ड विद द रिजल्टेंट ऑफ फाई मैक्स which is rotating from the unshaded portion to the shaded portion along the length of the pole face for portion O to A, A to B and B to C. These are the three basic regions we have already discussed for the supply cycle, okay, corresponding to the half cycle of the supply voltage. Then the application of this type of motor due to their low starting torque and reasonable cost, these motors are mostly employed in small instruments such as hair dryers, toys, record players, small fans, electric clocks, etc. These motors are usually available in a range of 1 by 300 to 1 by 20 kilowatt. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you. Thank you so much.